let's talk about some different techniques for scaling, different approaches you might take in a particular problem. So the first thing you should think about is optimizing your code. You know, if you have the option between buying a second machine and figuring out how to have two machines working together on your website versus making your code twice as fast, you know, maybe it's easier to optimize your code. You know, there are some trade-offs here. The cost of a machine plus the maintenance of having multiple machines. It means you need to figure out, you know, you have to administrate these machines, make sure they're up, configure them, make two machines work together, all that stuff, versus cost per developer. That is development time. You know, it takes some effort to optimize your code. And, you know, paying people to do that, or paying yourself, or, you know, considering the value of your own time for optimizing code versus adding another machine, you know, there's a trade-off there, and that's something you should think about. At my company, that's something we think a lot about. You know, what does it cost to pay a developer, and what does it cost just to add another machine? So kind of a big trade-off there. We're not going to spend a whole lot of time on this, on code optimization in this lecture, because that's really just learning how to program better. You know, as you get more experience programming, you'll be able to write better and tighter code. And, you know, as you understand how compilers work, you can start getting even more clever, and et cetera, et cetera. So won't be covering it in this lecture, but you'll get better at it as you develop as an engineer. Another technique is caching complex operations. We are going to spend a lot of time on this in this lecture. So I'm not going to say a whole lot about it now, but this is the name of the game, caching. You can upgrade your machines, which basically means, you know, replacing the machines you're using now with machines that have more memory, more disk space, faster CPU. Now, this is often a good option. Sometimes you don't have this option at all if you're using, you know, a shared platform where you don't have control of the machines. But again, you know, some every couple of years, machines get substantially faster, memory gets cheaper, disk space gets cheaper, CPUs come in faster varieties and greater numbers. So again, you know, just like you're doing the trade-off with code optimization versus adding more machines, you have the same trade-off here. Do we want to optimize our code, or do we just want to get a faster computer? This is a perfectly fine way to scale. And in fact, it's one of the easiest ways to scale if you have a system for replacing one machine with another without breaking your website. Or maybe you want to break your website for a little bit while you do this. So anyway, something to keep in mind. Sometimes it's an option, sometimes it's not. You know, it's not as fun as optimizing your code, but it's often cheaper and easier. And finally, another approach is to add more machines, which we will also be spending a fair amount of time on in this lecture. You know, the optimizing code and upgrading machines are fairly straightforward. You know, do it when you can. Caching and dealing with multiple machines working together in a system are more difficult, but ultimately you'll have to do them at some point as your website gets large enough. And that is what we'll be spending the most time on in this lecture, is how these two things fit together. Okay, so let's move on to caching.